am I a professional web developer yet? Well, no, but I did make this. I made my own weather app. I'm about to start SheCodes Plus, which is an 8-week web development workshop by SheCodes. And SheCodes is an online learning platform that offers coding workshops for women. They currently have 4 main workshops. The most basic one is SheCodes Basics, which teaches you the basics of HTML, CSS, and JavaScript in 3 weeks. I completed that one earlier this year, and I made this amazing website about sparkling water, which is my favorite thing ever. And you can check out this video for a full review. Then the next level workshop is SheCodes Plus, which is what I'm gonna start today. And then there's also SheCodes Responsive and SheCodes React, which I already bought both of them, and I will take and review them in the future. By the way, hey, my name is Anna, and I'm a German mechanical engineer based in Sweden. So SheCodes Plus, huh? Is it worth it? Let's find out. So, I just finished the first week. This week was pretty fun and easy. It was basically focused on refreshing the knowledge of HTML and CSS that I learned in the first course, SheCodes Basics. I also learned that throughout the next 8 weeks, I'm gonna be building a weather application where you can search for the weather of any city. And I get to design and code it myself, which is really exciting. And for this week's homework, that was really easy, was no coding at all, which is apparently how you should start a project, by planning it before you start coding. So I had to draw the wireframe of my website, or of my weather app, which is basically a drawing of the website, of the functions and elements before you code it. And there's a software for that, so I learned how to use InVision freehand, and I made this drawing of my weather app. And I very easily finished within 1 week, so everything's going great.
But things would quickly take a turn.
Okay, full transparency. I've been traveling a lot for work and I fell behind. I didn't code for over a week. But don't worry. I requested an extension and I'm all caught up with the course now. So I just finished week 2. This week was all about learning more things you can do with HTML and CSS, like using any font for your website or positioning elements exactly where you want them. And Bootstrap, which is basically a library of CSS elements, and it's super useful. And the homework was to convert my wireframe from week 1 into HTML and CSS. So now it looks like this. None of the functions are working yet, obviously, because I didn't use any JavaScript yet, but the basic layout is there. Week 3 was finally all about JavaScript. I refreshed my JavaScript knowledge from the previous workshop, and I learned lots of new good stuff, like using arrays, objects, loops, and so much more. Surprise! I messed up again. I didn't manage to do it within 1 week because of work and travel and YouTube and Netflix. But it's all good because I can get the weather of any city. Well, as long as it's one of these 5 cities. And it's also made up data and not actual weather data yet. So I still have a long way to go, but you know, one step at a time. So, I just finished week 4, and this week I learned a lot more about JavaScript compared to the week before. I learned things like how to use arguments and parameters in JavaScript functions, how to get a timestamp of the current time and date that you can then use for your website, and how to do something with the input that someone enters into, like a form or search bar. And I was already able to use these for my homework. So my website can now display the current time and weekday. It can convert the temperature between Celsius and Fahrenheit, and display the name of the city that you type into the search bar. So that's pretty exciting. In the following 2 weeks, I coded as much as this planned. So Mr. Planned, how much did you code in the past 14 days?
I did not code at all, actually.
Well, isn't that relatable? Me neither. Full transparency, it is now week 7, if you don't count the 3 extensions I did, and I have only completed week 4 of the workshop. So I am very, very behind. What I decided to do is I decided to finish week 5, 6, 7, and 8 in one weekend. Because 1, I need to film this review, and 2, I'm going to be starting a YouTube course called Master YouTube by Mattiavella on Monday. And if I know one thing for sure, is that I'm not gonna be able to follow 2 courses at the same time while also working full-time as an engineer and making videos. So yeah, there's no way. It's not how SheCodes intended the workshops to be done. You're supposed to follow them week by week at a moderate pace, but oh well. It's 9:22 p.m. on a Friday evening right now. I basically have 48 hours to finish 4 weeks of the workshop and film the review video. Wish me luck. All right, it is now 1:20 a.m. and I just completed week 5 in about 4 hours. I can already interact with an API, which is really cool if you ask me. Come on, ask me. Is this really cool or what? Yes, dude.
Okay,
I'm a little bit too tired. So, the weather app isn't completely finished yet, but I can already type in any city and get the current temperature in that city. And I also added a little blue button that you can use to search your current location and get the weather from there. So, if I turn this around, this is my little application, and if I search for a city, it gets the current temperature from that city from an API. And if I click on this little button here and allow Google to know my location and wait a little bit, ta-da, it gets my current location and the temperature at my current location. Isn't that so cool? Anyway, I'm really happy with my progress today. So I finished week 5. I still have week 6, 7, and 8 to go this weekend, and I have 2 days. So let's go to bed and continue tomorrow morning. Good night. Hello. It's the next day, about 2 p.m. and I just finished week 6, which took me, I don't know, maybe 2 hours or so. It was quite quick because this week was all about hosting and using GitHub, which is really fun. Let me show you. So first I learned how to install Git and how to use GitHub, which is basically a platform where you can upload all of your code, and every time that you make a change, you can publish or push the changes so that anyone can see it if you keep it public. And this is also something that recruiters can look at to see how you code and what kind of projects you do, how often you code and stuff like that. And then I learned how to use Netlify to host my website. So I basically connected GitHub to Netlify, and then I was able to publish it. So now if you search for this URL, then you can find my little weather app. All in all, this week was really successful, I feel like, or this week that I did in 2 hours. I learned a little bit about development workflow, and I feel like just it all makes a lot more sense now to me. I'm understanding these things a lot more. Even though I could probably have found all of this knowledge online, it's presented in a really good way. So I am loving this course right now. It's almost 2:30 now, and I really need to go for a run and have some lunch and film a video. And then I'll be back with some more coding and hopefully get week 7 done today as well. So only week 7 and week 8 left. Let's go. I have some regrets. Oh hey, some time has passed since the last video. It's now Sunday afternoon, so I've been working a little bit on the code since last night, but I also was doing a lot for YouTube. But now I'm back at it, and I've been tweaking the design a little bit. I finished all of the lessons for week 7, and now I still have to finish the homework. So let me show you what I'm supposed to do for the homework. It says here that I should improve the project, including the search engine, API integration, unit conversion, win speed, weather description, and weather icon. So I have some of these things already. This is the current status of the website. So I do have a search engine, and the city can update, and I also can update the time here and the day, as well as do a unit conversion between Fahrenheit and Celsius. So that's working already, but I still need to update the weather icon based on the weather. And I also want to link everything to a different API, since I found out that SheCodes offers their own weather API, which has a little bit more selection of icons and is also a little bit easier to integrate. And then maybe I will still adjust the styling as well, because I still don't like how the search bar looks like. But first I'm gonna go to the gym, because it's important to take breaks in between so that I'm fresh in my brain again. Quick status update. I finished the homework for week 7, which took me about maybe 3 or 4 hours, quite a bit of time, but I did it. It fulfills all the requirements. There's still some details I want to fix later, but I handed it in. I'm fine with it for now. And I know I said I would complete all 8 weeks by today. I don't think so. It's about 11 in the evening right now. So I'll probably start some lectures for week 8, and then I will finish tomorrow, hopefully. Fingers crossed. I think it's fine. It's really difficult to estimate how long it takes to code something, especially like as a beginner like me. So I'm very happy with the progress, and I'll see you tomorrow. I did it! I finished week 8, which means I finished the whole course! Am I a professional web developer yet? Well, no. But I did make this. I made my own weather app. So, was SheCodes Plus worth it? For me, the answer is yes. I learned exactly what I wanted to learn, I had lots of fun, and I'm really proud of what I've built. It's obviously quite expensive, but I really value that the knowledge is presented in a way that's logical and easy to follow. There's just no way that I would have spent the time and effort to gather all this knowledge from all kinds of different places on the internet, and been this consistent with working on a project without the lesson plans and homework deadlines. The instructor Matt is also great at explaining and can be really funny sometimes. So if you also value these things, then I can highly recommend this workshop. But if you value your money more than the time that this workshop could save you, then it's probably not for you. Now, what's next? I've been really wanting to build my own website because I have a really cool idea, if I may say so. And after this course, I finally feel confident enough to build it myself. I even now know how I can host it for free, which was a big question mark for me before, and how I can save my code on GitHub so that it's always safely stored somewhere. And I can even then share it with other people if I have questions. I also know how to inspect the code of any website that I like so that I can easily copy elements from them. So I'm really excited to use these skills for my own website. And I'm also going to be taking SheCodes Responsive and SheCodes React in the future to continue my learning. One thing that I've noticed though is that it's super important to code consistently and not take long breaks in between like I did at times, because it's so easy to forget. Coding is so much more fun if you actually remember all the things that you need instead of having to look up everything constantly. So that means I basically have to get started with this website right now before I forget, which means I gotta end this video, but I'll make sure to film the whole process of me coding my own website, so stay tuned for that. Thank you so much for watching, I really appreciate it, and I hope to see you in my next video. Bye!